The European Patent Office podcasts bring you an insight into the technology and innovation shaping the world.
Hello, and welcome to this podcast on patents and the fourth industrial revolution. I am Francesco Zaccà. At the European Patent Office, I am responsible for the patent granting activities in the field of mobility and mechatronics, a sector with 1,500 examiners and administrative staff. The European Patent Office is the patent granting authority in Europe. We are using our experience with patents to understand more about the fourth industrial revolution and its impact on technologies and economies around the world. It is estimated that in just 3 years' time, there will be 29 billion connected devices in the world. So that's more than three smartphone or 5G-enabled sensors or other gadgets for every man, woman, and child. The contribution to the European economy from this sector will exceed 2 trillion euros by the end of this decade. The impact of the fourth industrial revolution is going to be enormous. But which countries are forging ahead and which are falling behind? So let's see what this will bring. But before starting talking about the fourth industrial revolution, just let me give a very short summary about the first three. The first was the 19th century, coal, steam, textile factories. The second, 19th-20th century, transportation, cars, trains, oil industry, combustion engines. The third was electronics, computers, and telecommunication. And now we have the fourth, which means ubiquitous connectivity of people and of things, which generate enormous amount of data, which need huge computing power and very advanced software like artificial intelligence. While energy was the main driver of industrial development in the previous three industrial revolutions, now the essential driver of the fourth industrial revolution is data. If we can characterize the fourth industrial revolution with just one essential element, this is data. As you may have heard frequently, data is the new oil. Those who have more data have more power and more wealth. After this very short introduction, let me now introduce the two speakers, my EPO colleagues, who will help us understand the fourth industrial revolution and its impact on the economies and societies. First, a technical expert, Norbert Wienold. Hello, Norbert.
Hello, Francesco. Thank you very much for the introduction. I am Norbert Wienold, and I'm a patent examiner in the field of ICT in particular. I work in databases and business methods. Additionally, I work in the classification of patent documents in EPO. Some words to the question, what is classification? Because that's important for our study and for this talk. Like in a library, books are classified, for example, garden books, language books, etc. This classification leads to an index, which later on helps you to find those books back, if you want to buy them, if you want to read them, to find them in a library. And the same problem we have in our patent office. We have patent documents, actually these are books, comprising technical information. We have to find these patent documents back. And for this reason, we have developed a classification system, basically classifying all fields of technology. This is actually my second task in the EPO, that I help in developing such classification systems for technological art. We've done this as well now for the fourth industrial revolution. And this classification system we have developed for the fourth industrial revolution is then used now for the study to find back the relevant prior art or the relevant technical documents, which give us details about the fourth industrial revolution.
Thank you, Norbert. So I understand among all the millions of patents, you know where the patents related to the fourth industrial revolution can be found. Good. First starting point. Now we have an economist, my colleague Yann Ménière. Yann, good. Hello. How can you introduce yourself?
Hello, Francesco. Yes. So I'm the chief economist of the office. And as such, I lead a small team of economists and data analysts. And our main role is to produce studies in order to measure the impact of the patent system on the economy. Among these studies, some of them use the EPO's ability to monitor technologies in order to detect key technological trends and to document the way in which they will impact and transform the economy and the industry. And the study we are discussing today is one of those technology trend studies. And for such studies, we typically team up with experts in the field, like Norbert, who help us exploit the wealth of patent data that we have at the office in order to detect the patents connected to the technologies we are interested in. And with such data, we are able to document, to highlight the innovative activities of companies, countries, and regions, not only in Europe, but in the whole world.
Thank you, Jan. I have given a short introduction about the fourth industrial revolution, but can you explain better what is it precisely?
Yes, sure. So it's what I would call a mega trend of today's innovation landscape. It's a trend that we had detected some years ago, actually. And this trend encompasses many technologies that are currently hyped, like big data, artificial intelligence, 5G, or the Internet of Things. All of these technologies are disruptive per se, but in order to appreciate the full impact that they can have, you need to take a step back, put them into context, and take the full picture of how these technologies interact. And the interaction, the complementarity between these technologies is precisely the scope of the fourth industrial revolution. And together, it is together that they enable the transition towards a data-driven economy.
Thank you, Jan. You mentioned the impact. In fact, what is the impact on the economy?
So the impact is rather massive, and it's important to emphasize that it's very transversal. So these technologies are pervasive, and the impact spans all the sectors, or virtually all the sectors of the economy, which makes the estimation a bit challenging. But there are estimates, and for instance, according to the European Commission, the cumulative additional GDP contribution of these new digital technologies could amount to about 2.2 trillion euros in the EU alone by 2030. This represents more than a 40% increase from 2017.
Whoa, trillions. Whoa. Jan, what is the impact then on the industries and on the countries?
It's set to have a deep impact. It will likewise have a deep impact on the wealth of nation, as economists would say. Actually, we already have some countries, some players in the world that are front runners in developing these technologies, and that are shaping tomorrow's economy for the years and possibly the decades to come. For instance, the key countries and companies innovating in 5G. We may also have some countries that are able to secure durable growth by smartly specializing in some critical niche of 4IR technologies, most likely some other countries or countries that fail to upgrade, to adapt quickly to this new technological landscape may struggle and may see some sectors of their economy struggle or even disappear in the years to come.
Well, disappear, this is worrying. So let's understand better. What are the drivers of the fourth industrial revolution, Jan?
Previous industrial revolution have been all about replacing human or animal physical effort with machines, or more recently with computers. With the fourth industrial revolution, it goes much further. Actually, it's about replacing human intellectual effort with machine and with robot. Today, we have an amazing ability to collect, to share, and to process massive amount of data. And this makes it possible to automate complex tasks on an unprecedented scale. And that means that these complex tasks can be processed without any human intervention anymore. Another one that is important to emphasize is that it is all data-driven. It is estimated by 2023, there will be more than 29 billion devices that will be connected to internet. And most of these devices will be creating data in real time. This data make it possible to monitor in a very detailed way the physical environment of the objects. And once aggregated, they can be analyzed. And using tools such as artificial intelligence, it is possible to trigger very quickly, instantly, almost a smart response in the real world without any human intervention.
Thank you, Jan. So yes, data is the fuel and the currency of the fourth industrial revolution. And what kind of contribution do you expect that we, in the world of patent, can give to this with our study?
As the Patent Office for Europe, we at the EPO are at the forefront of these transformations. We are the first to see the patent applications. This puts us in a unique position to appreciate the breadth and the implications of these changes. So we are also blessed with sitting on a pile of great data. We feel it is our responsibility to share the insights we can get on technological change with our stakeholders and with the general public to help them prepare and make good policy to adapt these changes. As Norbert already said, patent databases contains the latest technical information, much of which cannot be found in other sources. And in particular, the EPO's Free Espacenet database contains, for instance, more than 120 million patent documents from around the world. This patent information provides early indication of technological developments that are bound to transform the economy, of inventions that are bound to reach the market soon. And at the EPO, we have the data and we have the skills to interpret this data, to analyze this data, and in order to provide meaningful insights to the public. So this is our purpose with this study.
Thank you. So we have the data, we have the classification, but can you explain better how you do that? Maybe Norbert.
Actually, we have a unique ability to search and analyze this information. And this is due to the expertise of all the EPO examiners, which are highly specialized experts in all fields of technology. And this is quite important. And we have now mapped the patent information to all the different fields of technology of the fourth industrial revolution. And here I would like to mention that while I'm the technical expert here in this podcast and also in the study, I was not alone. Actually, I've worked together with more than 200 experts in the field to identify all the fields where we can found potentially patents of the fourth industrial revolution. And actually, we have identified, I've counted it, 368 technical fields where we can find such patent information. And the question is, why do we have selected beforehand these technical fields? The problem is, if we would just search for, let's say, certain keywords, trying to find a related prior art, and we would do that everywhere, then we would retrieve a lot of wrong information. And the question is, so we were actually asking our experts whether they can lead us directly to the best places where we can find the right documents and not something which reads similar, but is actually talking about something else. And for this reason, we have used the knowledge of our experts. And I think this is what makes the study so unique, because it's based on the knowledge of several hundreds of experts in the field.
Absolutely. And this is so the work of Norbert and his colleagues has made it possible for us to map patent data to the different building blocks, the different technology fields of the fourth industrial revolution. And then this is the moment when the analysts step in order to make this data speak. And for that, in this study, we have focused on what we call international patent families. So we have identified all international patent families related to the fourth industrial revolution, each international patent family being one invention, usually of high value, for which patent protection has been sought at the international scale in two or more countries. And in the report, we use this metric as a measure of innovation in order to document technological trends, but also to benchmark the performance and the specialization profile of countries, of top companies, as well as regional innovation clusters around the world.
Yann, you mentioned several technologies that are already becoming indispensable to the modern economy. Now, Norbert, can you provide us with more details, with a map of these relevant technologies, just to give more structure and guidance and explain how you can identify these?
The fourth industrial revolution inventions are different from other inventions. I would like to give an example. Think of a car. A car has been known since 100 years. Now, what we see is that to the normal car, technology is added like sensors. Sensors provide information about, for example, the state of brakes, the state of the motor, fueling level. So you get information about your car in digital form. Then you add, for example, GPS to the vehicle. So the vehicle knows exactly its position. Now you add communication technology to your vehicle. Now this information can be communicated, for example, to a central control system. The car itself can actually download information about the road situation in front of it, for example, to avoid icy roads, for example, or any other problems. This combination of traditional, let's say, cars, now equipped with what we call ICT means, so the processors, the sensors, the communication means, together with now artificial intelligence, allowing the vehicle to make decisions on its own at the spot when it has to decide to turn left or to turn right, for example. The whole combination of all these features, technical features applied to a car, this is what we understand to be a fourth industrial revolution invention. And that's actually the type of inventions we have been looking for in the study.
Thank you, Norbert. Now to Yann. We have understood now what you wanted with the study, how you have organized it, the technologies involved. But now comes the interesting part. So I just want to know, what did you find?
We actually found first confirmation that is indeed a mega trend that we are talking about. So the trend starting two decades ago, but we observed that the patenting activities in smart connected objects have dramatically accelerated during the past decade, with an average annual growth rate close to 20% from 2010 to 2018. So 20% every year. As compared with 4.2% on average for all technology fields during the same period. So it's really a very fast growth. And it's also very important in terms of volume. And in 2018, these inventions related to smart connected objects represented more than 11% of patenting activity worldwide, with nearly 40,000 new international patent families and 45% of the patent growth in 2018. So it's really a big share of all patenting activities, despite being based on a rather restrictive definition of a smart connected object.
So which are the areas impacted strongest by the fourth industrial revolution technologies?
We have structured and used the patent data in order to be able to track innovation across a wide variety of application domains. And we observed a similar pattern of a very fast growth in all of them. So it's really pervasive in that respect. But then we see differences in terms of volume. So some of them are more advanced. It started earlier. And this is in particular the case for smart consumer goods, such as smart watches, smart glasses, and so on, where we have the largest number of patenting activity, which started already in two decades ago and has been further accelerating in the last 10 years. So, for instance, we observe more than 58,000 international patent families between 2010 and 2018 in this field of smart consumer goods. But it's not restricted to that. And we see also large volumes of patenting in smart services, such as smart payments, smart health, or smart vehicles.
I think Yann mentioned it already that in particular in the areas of vehicles, the self-driving vehicles, we see a lot of innovation going on, like taxi services or car sharing, and this is all driven by the fourth industrial revolution, in particular also by AI, to provide services for, let's say, cities where we have less cars owned by an owner, but actually shared vehicles which can then used by everybody. And here we see a lot of going on also on the service level, and I think this might help in the future to get our cities greener with less traffic and hopefully with more free time for all the inhabitants of the cities.
Now, another important thing, where is this happening? So, Yann, which regions or countries are contributing the most? Do you get some information from your data?
Yes, actually, with the patent data, you have information on the inventors and their location. So you can use their addresses to input inventions to the countries of origins, to the place where the research and development activities have been taken place. And in that respect, we see that the US, the United States, is by far the most innovative world region in 4IR technologies, with about one third of all the patenting activities between 2000 and 2010, and a strong presence in all technology sectors of the fourth industrial revolution. So not a particular specialization, it's really across the board. And so this lead of the United States was already present in the 2000-2010 period, but the US further reinforced it after 2010 with a faster growth of innovation activities as compared to the next two followers, Europe and Japan. So if we look at these two ones, Europe and Japan, they each account for about one-fifth of all patenting activities in the fourth industrial revolution since 2000. So they remain important players. But what we can also observe in the recent years, in the past decade, is the fast rise of new innovation centers, namely the People's Republic of China and the Republic of Korea. Both of them have almost caught up at this stage with Japan and with Europe due to a very impressive growth of their innovation activities in the past 10 years. So in the case China, it's a 25% growth rate on average every year since 2010. And in the case of Korea, it's almost 40% every year since 2010. And these two players are especially specialized in core technology fields, such as IT hardware, software, and connectivity. So they are more focused on one part of the technology landscape and perhaps a bit less on applications of the fourth industrial revolution technologies in different industry sectors. So when we look more closely at Europe and the way in which Europe specializes, contributes to innovation in fourth industrial revolution, we see that the landscape in Europe is dominated by Germany, which alone contributed about 6% of all patenting activities on a global scale since 2000, and nearly one third of all the patenting activities coming from Europe in the same period. Then come next the United Kingdom and France, with much smaller levels of contribution, like 2.8% at the world scale for the United Kingdom, and same thing for France. So that's the picture for the large European countries. Clearly, Germany stands out there, thanks to the car industry in particular. But it's also interesting to look at smaller European countries, and this is where we see the most promising performances. You have countries like Sweden or Finland or Switzerland or the Netherlands that host important innovation clusters and that have a very impressive performance in terms of innovation per inhabitant, so in terms of intensity of productivity of innovation, as well as growth. Actually, if you take Sweden in particular, the growth rate annually of patenting in fourth industrial revolution technologies in the past 10 years has been 22.6%, which is above the world average. And we find similarly in Switzerland a growth rate of nearly 20%. So these countries are really performing well, but you have to look at the country level to see that, because these are small countries.
Thank you, Yann. Thank you, Robert. Now, we have seen we are close to the end of this conversation. We understood better what is the fourth industrial revolution, what is the impact, which is huge, and which technologies and which regions it impacts. Now, before we close, I would like to ask a personal question to each of you. What is your favorite fourth industrial revolution invention? Norbert first.
For me, it's clearly the autonomously driving vehicles. So consider that you're sitting in such a car and you just have to believe or to hope that it is driving you safely to the place you want to go to. And so this needs so much trust that the efforts all the companies have to do to verify that we can trust this car. This is such an effort that I think that this is for me actually the most complex technical innovation of the last decades. And for this reason, that's my favorite.
Thank you, Norbert. Indeed, autonomous vehicles are a great thing in the future to come. Jan?
I've been watching these developments for some years now, and I must say that to me the most fascinating part is that there is a virtually infinite potential for applications of fourth industrial revolution technologies in various application domains. And the exciting part is to see when this potential materializes over time, and to discover what is the next invention to come. So I'm always waiting for the next one, and I'm especially curious about the ones that are unexpected, so that are related to, well, kind of daily products, daily services, daily activities that can become smart. For instance, a smart insulin pump, a smart way of milking cows, or a smart way of drying concrete. And what is interesting to me there as an economist is that with this smart transformation, these smart add-ons of a traditional product, there is room for innovation for all types of players, including SMEs. So any SMEs in any traditional industry can find a way to make its business smart using the technologies of the fourth industrial revolution.
Thank you, Jan. And I would like also to give an answer myself to the question I asked. For me, thanks to the fourth industrial revolution, I see that this pandemic that we are living is the first in the human history where physical distancing, which is necessary, does not automatically and necessarily imply social and professional distancing, as it was in the past. So today, the fourth industrial revolution helped an organization like mine, the European Patent Office, which is a knowledge organization with thousands of staff. It helped us to respond to the pandemic emergency with an incredible and unimaginable speed and effectiveness. In a matter of weeks, all staff received a laptop that enabled them to work wherever they have an internet connection, and most of us started working remotely. In just a few months, all our processes have been digitalized. So thanks to connectivity, to data and software, so in fact, thanks to the fourth industrial revolution, we have remained fully operational. Our staff continue interacting among themselves, with the applicants. The administrative council meetings are held online. Now also the hearings in the opposition proceedings are going online. And I think this is a great result of the fourth industrial revolution. Now we come to the conclusion of this conversation. So many thanks to Norbert Wienold and to Yann Ménière. This was a truly fascinating conversation about the fourth industrial revolution and the real impact it has on industries and economies.
Subscribe to the European Patent Office's podcast channel, Talk Innovation, at epo.org or on your favorite podcast platform. Let's talk innovation.